Alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Amma ba'da, habita fillah, a question was asked. Assalamu alaikum, Ustad. May Allah place barakah in your work. Ameen. Wa iyyakum. I wanted to ask a common occurrence when living in Western countries that you go to doctors or to see the nurse and the only one available is a woman, or the only one, or there are only women doctors at some institutions. In these situations, is it allowed to see them knowing that it will only be you and her in the room in a time of necessity? Jazakallah khairan. So first and foremost, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us in you and preserve us in you and make all of our affairs easy. Ameen. Ya Rabbil Alameen. This is not just the case in the Western countries. In fact, I would say, and this may be a bit of an over-exaggeration, that you're only going to find this practice with the Taliban or something, that you're going to have the strict, stringent separation of sexes. I live in Saudi Arabia. I have to see female dentists all the time without any choices. Nurses all the time, female nurses of various nationalities. So this is generally not practiced anywhere. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, "Taqullaha mastata'tum." Fear Allah as much as you are able to. So that is the job of the mu'min, is to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as much as he or she is able to. So if you have the choice, then take that choice. If you don't, obviously you need to get your teeth cleaned. Obviously you need that dental surgery. Obviously you need to fix that and mend that broken limb or whatever the case may be. This is just the reality of what you have to deal with. So you fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as much as you can. And we ask Allah the Almighty to accept our good and forgive our evil. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad.